You must oblige us. You understand the consequences of your decision.
Do not patronize me, Asmath. For I understand all too well. Yes, I violate the law in defying the council. But if I were to give you this scepter, my crime would be graver yet, for I would be defying my conscience and our people. Have you all forgotten? This council was created to protect the people of Izmir. But ask yourselves, is this what you are doing? I say not. Your concern is only for yourselves, not the people.
And your majesty is forcing the empire to the verge of civil war in the best interests of the people.
The man who convinced you to take the scepter from me so that he would leave the state defenseless. Be careful, my friends, for once he's done with me, this council may be next. War benefits no one, Prothean, and I oppose it. But if it is necessary to obtain the freedom of our people, then no cost could be too great to achieve that goal.
Do you hear her words?
She violates our highest law and then seeks to force us into submission with the threat of war.
Each citizen of Izmir, whether a commoner or a mage, deserves an equal right for prosperity. And as empress, this is how I decree Izmir shall be run from this day forward.
Such pretty words.
My friends, I warned you that this headstrong child will defy you and destroy you. Her youth denies her the wisdom to understand why some things cannot change. But idealism is for children, and a child is not fit to govern an empire. I ask you one last time, will you submit to the ruling of this council and relinquish your scepter?
I was praying that you would find the wisdom to see that the path I propose for Izmir is the right one. I do not wish to fight you, but I will not leave the empire at the mercy of an unscrupulous charlatan. So decide as you must, but know one thing. I am not afraid.
A wonderful performance. My friends, ask yourselves, are we prepared to see our empire destroyed by a child? Then is now not the time we should act. Then down with the tyrants and let the war begin.